G'day, Reds fans. Welcome once again to RedsTV. I'm Nick McArdle. Thanks very much for your company. This week, we've got plenty of great stuff happening for you. We're going to recap the Reds' encounter with the Hurricanes, and stay tuned for some behind-the-scenes action from that one that you can't see anywhere else. And before we take a look at how the Premier Rugby competition went over the weekend, let's take a look back at the highlights from the Reds' clash with the Canes on the Sunshine Coast.
With the Super Rugby season taking a break for the inbound test matches, the Reds staged an exhibition match against the Wellington Hurricanes at Stockland Stadium on the Sunshine Coast. Led out for the first time by Ben Lucas, the team had quite a few unfamiliar faces, but it wasn't long before fan favourite Radiki Samo had fans cheering with a trademark run. It was an opportunity for Premier Rugby players like Damon Murphy from Brothers to show the Reds coaching staff that they had the ability to play at the next level. The Reds built solid pressure after conceding the first try of the match and were unlucky to turn it over deep in Hurricanes territory. The visitors made them pay through what was arguably the play of the game. Jake Schatz was strong around the ruck and made numerous steals for the Reds. Young Academy product Mitchell Wade followed Schatz's lead by forcing a turnover of his own.
Release Gray! Yeah, where you are.
In the 55th minute, the boys from Ballymore were rewarded for their hard work as they drove the ball hard through the forwards for Guy Shepherdson to crash over. Unfortunately, this was the only time the Reds crossed the white line, but they never gave up, with winger Dom Shipley showing a never-say-die attitude to deny the Hurricanes a late try. Although the Reds finished on the wrong side of the scoreboard, the game was a success for grassroots rugby, with over 5,000 Sunshine Coast rugby supporters turning out to watch the stars of today mix it with the future talent of Queensland rugby.
Some spectacular rugby was played out in week 8 of the Premier Rugby competition, and the title contenders have started to build a gap on the rest of the field, with 4th place Jeeps 8 points clear of 5th place Sunnybank. Brothers returned to the winner's circle with a solid win over the Gold Coast at home. Both teams started well, and the game looked to be a tight contest early on, but the Brethren's class proved too strong for the Breakers as they cruised to a convincing 48-27 point victory. A late try to West flanker Kirk Hawkins sealed a victory for the Bulldogs over Souths at Chipsywood Oval. The Magpies held a 9-point lead at half-time, but it was West who resumed the second half, keen to make their intentions clear. Two tries to Brad Cameron helped give the Bulldogs the lead, and the last-minute try to Hawkins gifted West the 4 points, taking the game 25-17. The match of the round certainly lived up to expectation, as Jeeps and East did battle at Yoku Road. East applied early pressure, but the momentum changed when winger Josh Logan took an intercept to put Jeeps on the board with a try against the run of play. Jeeps wasted opportunities, and the Tigers remained patient as they built pressure to take the lead midway through the second half. East never looked back, and despite a late try to Jeeps fullback Pat Smith, the Tigers held on to win 22-18. University have continued the Sunshine Coast woes in 2012 with a thumping 71-12 victory at home. Winger Elliot Hagen put the boot into his old club, crossing the paint 3 times in the 11-2 routing of the Cellar Dwellers. North travelled to Sunnybank looking for back-to-back victories for the first time this year, and they looked to be on their way as they took a 14-12 lead into half-time. The Dragons seemed to wake from their slumber, however, and in the second half, they piled on 14 unanswered points to walk away 26-14 point victors. The Musashi High Performer of the Week for Round 8 goes to East captain Matt Brandon. Brandon displayed a cool head and a reliable boot to guide East home in their victory over Jeeps at Yoku Road. Congratulations, Matt. Enjoy that Musashi prize pack. Round 9 marks the halfway point of the 2012 Premier Rugby season, and East will play host to University in this week's match of the round. The Tigers' rock-solid defence will be looking to shut down the Students' strong attacking game as both teams look to consolidate their positions in the top four.
The other matches in Round 9 see Brothers travel to Stockland Stadium to take on the Stingrays. West will welcome Jeeps to the Kennel at Sylvan Road. Norths will take on Souths at Hugh Courtney Oval. And Sunnybank will travel to Albert Park to take on the Gold Coast Breakers. This week, RedsTV has gone behind the scenes with Team Rehab to see all the hard work that goes into getting the players back to 100% and back on the field. First of all, we speak to Peter Hines about his recovery. How's the knee coming along, Hinesy?
I look pretty well. It's a long, slow process and there's a lot of steps along the way, and we just take it one step at a time, and at this stage it's progressing really well and we're making progress, so that's the most important thing. You've got to build the muscle back up, get it strong and get it controlled so you can run, basically. I think the most important thing is to set goals, and my goal is to play again. So every time I see the boys training out there, it gives me a little bit of inspiration. So, you know, I'm pretty confident of getting back out there one day.
Yeah, hopefully, you know, it's a bit of a slow process, but once I get the brace off, then I can look to be back running and hopefully make the last few games. Well, at the moment, I can't do too much, so I'm still in the knee brace and waiting for it to really heal up. And then the next few weeks when I get this off, I'll strengthen it, get the muscle back, and straight back into the running and contact again. It's tough being in here, doing all the work by yourself and seeing the boys play as well. It gets tough, but you know, you just got to keep motivated and keep your head up and see the light at the end of the tunnel, I guess. If you're a professional athlete, the motivation is always to get back to the top, so, and for me, that's, you know, very much the case. So I want to get back into the starting team, and that's enough motivation for me.
As you can tell by looking at me at the moment, working hard. A few of the boys in Team Rehab got an upper body conditioning circuit which Ollie's built up. It's pretty tough.
You suffered an ankle injury. Are you doing any work on that putty body at the moment, or is it more conditioning the rest of the body till it's ready?
A lot of conditioning the rest of the body till it's ready, but just a lot of physio and balance work on the ankle at the moment. Just seeing the boys play, like Wallabies and stuff, which helps with motivation. So I think just seeing your mates out there play, you want to get back out there.
Me and Benny Daly as front rows, we're just wondering what's the point of this drill and what are we doing?
Mate, just doing some sled pushes, doing a little bit of scrummaging technique work, holder hit and things like that, and some shuttle drill, just to kick the legs over, mate. Just gets a little bit of contact in for you, return to scrummaging, things like that, so tick those boxes, and when you're certainly not going in cold after a timeout, so.
Yeah, it's always tricky. Football is football. Unfortunately, you're going to get X amount of injuries throughout the season. It's the nature of the sport. It's always a big challenge. So depending on what type of injury they've got, will govern what's emphasised more. So in general, we'll strengthen up the muscles around the joint. We'll work on their proprioception, and we'll work on their ability to absorb forces. Once that's all done in the gym, or kind of at the same time as that's being done in the gym, we'll integrate that into some on-field stuff. So it's so the environment is similar to what they're going to go back to playing in. Yeah, it's critical for him on a number of levels. Physically, like I said before, from his proprioception point of view, it's a great thing just to keep him rolling and keeping that injury and getting better and better, and he's getting stronger and stronger. We build in some little challenges for them, and goal setting is quite a big part of rehab.
Kick, brother. That was actually the brainchild of James Horwell. But the thing with Team Rehab is we've got the aim to make it trending worldwide within weeks, so we're hopeful.
Come on,
we're a
tight
bunch, and we're just trying to get our message out there.
Come on, let's go.
There's only one bathroom in our house, so unfortunately he's pretty stinky and I get to have to deal with that a fair bit. But other than that, he's a pretty good landlord, we get along all right. I'm definitely red, there's no doubt about it. It's really only when it comes to State of Origin that I look back to my roots and go the Blues. There's a few of us like Jono Lance and Ben Daly that like to rip the native Queenslanders and get the Blues up.
That must have been a pretty tough 6 years for you then.
Oh, yeah, I suppose so, but good things come to those who wait.
Well, thanks again for joining me for another episode of Reds TV. Super Rugby action returns next week when the Reds reunite after the test window and head to Melbourne to take on the Rebels on Friday. It is a vital encounter with only three games remaining before the Super Rugby finals. Look out for it. I'm Nick McArdle. Best of luck once again to the Wallabies this weekend. I'll catch you next week.
Ball game.